Techniques used in this video may be dangerous. Do not try at home.
Should I turn it back on? Yeah, it just feels like burning, kind of. Is that supposed to happen? That's supposed to happen. Yeah.
So, I really want to electrocute my brain. I heard about this technology, TDCS, on a Radio Lab episode, which pretty much said I could be faster and think clearer and pretty much be smarter. So I want to try it for myself.
All over Reddit, people are making their own, and they're powered by just 9-volt batteries wired to homemade electrodes. So I asked my dad, who's an electrician, to make me one of these brain-shocking devices.
And he built me one. So let's try it. I'm gonna put this one on the right side and this guy on the left, and that's gonna help my learning. It definitely feels tingly. Do you want to electrocute your head?
Yeah. Feels like my head is tingly.
Uh-huh.
And it kind of feels like it's like pushing my head in.
Do you feel smarter?
I don't know, man.
Hey, Dimitri.
Yes.
We be part of this science experiment. And it's on. Do you feel any tingling?
No. Yeah, maybe. Can't tell if it's in my head or not.
What have you done? What is going on?
What had I done? There is no way electrocuting your head can be beneficial. I headed out to USC to get some answers.
So I was very interested in the possibility of using TDCS technology as a therapy for children with movement disorders. I work with children with cerebral palsy. What's thought is it's basically a battery. If you put a positive electrode on one part of your brain and a negative electrode on the other, the ones that are near the positive electrode makes the cells a little bit more likely to fire, and the one near the negative electrode makes it a little less likely to fire. So I'm hopeful that something like this will be useful. It's the holy grail of medicine. Non-invasive, cheap, painless thing that cures your disease without drugs. So far it's not there.
So TDCS is still in the research stages, even for professionals. How did I know if mine was working? I decided to do some research too.
So we rented this arcade game, which has Police Trainer, and we're gonna compare our scores before and after we shock our brains.
I had three people, including myself, get familiar with Police Trainer and then do a round without TDCS.
It's hard to tell the colors. Oh God, what?
Round one was not great. So we strapped the device to our head using a hat to hold it in place.
Holy shit. Weird. All right.
To make sure experience was not a factor, we played one more time without TDCS. But brain shocking still had better results.
Feels good. I feel good. I wish we had darts I could throw at my face. That way, maybe it's just because I'm wearing something on my head. And this is like drawing attention to the fact that this is life.
I don't know, it just seemed easier. Especially the one where it was like matching the colors. Like, it seemed like I had a long time to pause and look at the pictures before I shot. I don't know. It could just be because it was buzzing my head and it was feeling weird and all these things were happening all at once. But I don't know, I think it worked. Yeah, if the Apple Watch had one of these, I'd wear it all day.
So it could have been a placebo, but I think it worked, at least a little bit. And I know the technology's not there yet, but I could see a future where people skip the coffee and they juice their brains instead.
Hey guys, do not try this at home. The research isn't all in, and you definitely don't want to mess up your brain.